like my color. Yes. Anywho, I finally figured out the color thing in this camera. It shows me better when I'm outdoors. Maybe it's just the light at my home. I think it's the light at my home. Much better. Okay, guys. So I forgot to do the whole walkie-talkie session today, and I just got in my car. I realized that I forgot. I said, we can still catch up in the car. So that's what I'm doing. So, how is your workout, your whole lifestyle change, everything going? Jump rope session, I hope is going as planned. And if you hit a little bump, few bumps on the road here and there, is completely okay. Get back up. Get right on that path. Don't let anything whatsoever distract you from your goal. I didn't forget, actually. I was running late on in a Saturday or Sunday, I'm not sure which day. I was running late to work. So I couldn't get my jump rope session in. So what I did that day, instead of just completely ignoring the whole cardio session, I decided to actually go up down the stairs at my job. So the whole 30 minutes I had for my lunch break, I just went up and down the stairs, up and down 9 flights of stairs until my lunch break session was over. And I felt really good afterwards. And then, like a couple days afterwards, my leg, my thighs, my calves was in so much pain because the muscle in those areas were targeted. That's what I realized. And it was so painful days afterwards. So that tells me that that exercise was really good. It was really, really good. I know it will do my body a whole lot of good if I continue to do something like that. So I think I will incorporate that when I'm at work. At least maybe once a week, I'll go up and down those flights of stairs. Anyway, so that's working out for me. Hopefully you find something that works for you and you can stick to that. Something funny happened to me the other day. My friend came over. We hadn't seen each other in like a couple weeks or so, maybe more than a couple weeks. We hadn't seen each other in a while. So she came over. We greeted, good afternoon, good afternoon. How are you doing? Blah, blah, blah. And then the next thing that comes out of her mouth is, "Nah, you don't fatto." See, if you want late, if you are able late, you could have seen me. I won't be home when don't knock at Babu. Can you get who? Now I'm actually losing the weight. To SM, nah, I don't fatto. It dawned on me that I think it's a very Nigerian thing to be so blunt with each other, to be so unfiltered with each other, to not hold back. And I actually have said something like that to a friend. I think I said that to her. I said that to her before. Not like that, but I saw her like adding weight. This was when she first came to the States and, sampling all the Americana food, and she was adding up. I told her that do not get distracted, or you are seriously adding up and it's going to impact your health in a very negative way. And I told her that because, I consider her a close friend. And one thing about me, if you're a good friend of mine, if I consider you a good friend, then we really don't hide too much of the truth, okay, from each other. I try to be as honest as I can be with you. And I guess I'm more honest with my Nigerian friends because I know that if I said something like that to my Igbo friends, they might see it as coming from a hurtful mindset instead of genuine concern. So I had a laugh about it. We laughed about it, and she was saying the truth. I actually have added up, and I acknowledged that. I told her, I'm working on it, and I'm glad that she said something. I prefer a friend coming to me when they feel like I'm drowning and like trying to save me, than you just looking the other way and pretend that everything is okay. But when it comes to somebody who comes from a different culture than I do, I tread lightly because I don't want what I say to come off hurtful because that's not my intent. I appreciated what she said to me, But I know that some people might find that offensive. I did not, because I know that where she's coming from carries zero malice. And yeah, I told her, we had a discussion about it. I told her what I was doing to try to lose the weight. And she was curious, and she actually wanted to incorporate something like that in her lifestyle. So yeah, we had a little nice chit chat about it. When it comes to me seeing you giving up on your health status, when I know very much that you can control that, I have to say something. And I appreciate friends that come to me and tell me, like, look, you know, you need to do something. You need to do something. Your health is going to suffer if you
don't.
How will you approach a friend?
Hey guys, today is Tuesday. Tuesday the 2nd. And I have this little one here with me. And what's the hi?
Hi.
What else hi. Do you have to say?
This is my timer, and let me show you my backpack that my mom bought.
Okay, it's okay. It's okay, it. Nello. So once again, I did not wake up. I did not wake up by 6 a.m. So.
Isn't it beautiful? I can't tell you my sister's one, because my sister's going to school.
Okay. What is your backpack? So today we are working on the arms, right, Chinelo?
Yeah.
And then after the arms, what else?
We're working with jump ropes, and we're working with the muscle thingies.
The muscle thingies?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what we're doing today. We'll work on the arms, and then we'll also jump rope as well. And that should be it for today. Tomorrow we move on to the abs, and hopefully by the end of the week we can target the thighs.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I'm not even good at jump roping.
All right, guys. We'll see you in a bit. Hey guys, today is February the 6th. I did not get my workout in this morning. I was rushing to work. So I decided, instead of taking my lunch break, which I already ate, I decided to just come by and walk up and down the flight of stairs. That's another way to get your workout in. We have, I think, 9 stairs for me to climb up and down until my lunch break is over. So that's what I'm doing. Still getting my workout in. All right, guys, I'll see you guys in a few. Anyway, look at this. Check out the gorgeous view of downtown. I don't know if you can see it. Anyway, maybe I don't know if you can see it. Maybe when I go up, I'll show you guys what the view looks like. It's beautiful. When I get to the very top stairs, it is gorgeous. So this doesn't even feel like a workout. It's actually fun. Anyway, I'll see you guys in a bit. Bye. Hey guys, how are you guys doing? Today is Sunday the 7th of February, I believe. Today is my blood pressure check-in day. I look a little dewy, a little moist today because I just actually concluded my jump rope session for the day. And I almost forgot to take my blood pressure. I did forget, actually. I just remembered as I was walking out, it dawned on me, today is Sunday.
I need to have checked my blood pressure, okay?
So the reason I was telling you guys last week, you have to make sure that your time is consistent, because today I have a feeling that my numbers will be completely skewed. Completely skewed because I actually walked out before checking my blood pressure. So if you have any kind of rigorous activity before you do your blood pressure, before you check it, it should be higher than your norm. So I have a feeling that this one will be higher than what I'm actually going for. Higher than what it should be, basically, because I just walked out before checking in. But I still want to get my Sunday check-in done,
if that makes sense.
So, yeah, we'll just check it. I have a feeling that this number will be so wrong, but we'll just check it. So I have my cuff on. This particular brand, it calls for the hose, like you see right here, to be in line with the middle of your arm when you check your blood pressure. So I have everything aligned,
And I'm just going to press the start button. I don't know if you guys can hear that. So my blood pressure is being checked right now. Once I have the numbers, I'll let you guys know. I'm a little nervous. But we'll see what we get. I have my radio playing in the background. I listen to Wazobia FM. I like the Abuja station. I listen to the Abuja. I listen to Port Harcourt station. I also listen to Lagos. Abuja is my favorite. Second to that is Port Harcourt. And then my least favorite is Lagos. I just can't connect. I don't know why. My absolute favorite, the person I listen to the most on Abuja station is Expensive. And Big Mo. I love Big Mo. And then, is it? No, it's not Lady G. There's another one at night. I like Wooly Wooly, but usually whenever she comes on, I'm sleeping. There's another one at night. I've forgotten her name, but she's very, very good. Ooh, okay. Well, the numbers are good, surprisingly. I don't know what to make of this. I expected the numbers to be higher today because I just walked out and then I'm checking my blood pressure. I don't know how accurate this is. I really don't. Today is 117 over 81. I would have appreciated today's numbers if I had taken the pressure before I walked out. So I was thinking because I just walked out and then I took my blood pressure that the pressure would be higher. But now it's actually a little closer to my baseline than before. I don't know what to make of this. It's good. It's good, but I don't know. I'm not sure about these numbers. Anyway, next weekend, next Sunday, I will be able to take a more accurate blood pressure. And that one should be the one I will be going by. Not so sure about this one. Like I said before, I walked out, then I checked my blood pressure afterwards. So I don't know how accurate this is. This song is the bomb. Ah! They play really, really good music. You kind of have to understand pidgin, first of all. You have to understand, or you have to like Nigerian pop music. You have to like Nigerian high life music. You have to like Nigerian gospel music. And actually, if you like those kind of genre, you don't have to actually understand pidgin. Because I think music, the good thing about music is that it breaks barriers, language barriers. As long as you can actually sit and enjoy that kind of genre of music, then you're good. I love it. Number one example of language, of a song, songs, really good songs, just breaking language barriers. Do you guys remember this song from way back? Ahaye, 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 ahaye. I have no idea what she's saying in Hausa, but I remember loving this song as a kid. And I so do.
Here I am in the middle of the worst temptation. Temptation with this healthy diet. I am making some candy grams for two of my daughters, both of their classes. And there's about 60 something of those. I'm going to glue gun the candy to the cutout hat. Man, it's taking so much out of me to resist this hashi chocolate. Oh my goodness. But so far I'm doing okay. So far. Let's see how long that lasts.